the word problems. Okay, so we're looking here at the word problems, and I need to go over what's the angle of elevation and what is the angle of depression. Well, an angle of elevation works like this. If you are on the ground and you are looking up at the top of a tower, your angle of elevation is the angle you form with the horizontal ground, okay? So usually we just say from the ground up, but sometimes you're actually going to do it from your eye level up. So an angle of elevation is this angle right here, elevating upward from the horizontal up to the object. Okay, so what would be, so I'm going to call this the angle of elevation. Okay, now where would the angle of depression be? Well, it's a little deceiving, so don't let it deceive you. Okay, let's say that you're at the top and you've got a horizontal reference. Your angle of depression is actually this angle right here. Angle of depression. Okay, it's from the horizontal at the top looking down. So always draw a horizontal and a line down. Now, if you'll notice, these two sides are parallel, right? These horizontal reference points or reference lines. So really your angle of elevation and your angle of depression are equal to each other because these are alternate interior angles with two parallel lines, and here's your transversal. So these two will actually be the same measure, but you're going to draw them in different places as you reference these practice problems, the word problems. Okay, so now let's look at our word problem. Okay, let's kind of read it through it together. A 38-foot wire runs from a point on the ground to the top of a 24-foot flagpole. What is the angle of elevation? Okay, so we don't know the angle. That means we're going to have to use the inverse button, okay? So first thing we need to do is draw a picture. Then we're going to label what we know, and then we're going to set up and solve it, okay? So let's try to draw this picture. We have a 38-foot wire that runs from the top, from a point on the ground to the top of a flagpole. So let's draw a flagpole. So here's our flag. Okay, here's the top of the pole, and there's a wire that runs from the ground up, and that's a 38-foot wire. And we were told that the pole is 24 feet tall. So you want to draw and label your picture. Okay, now the flag's going to make a right angle with the ground, so draw your right angle in. Now let's see if we can look at the question. What's the angle of elevation? Well, in this diagram, where's our angle of elevation? It's from the ground up. So we're looking for this angle. So let's call this X. Okay, whoops, not writing very well. There we go. Okay. So which two sides do we have so we can decide on our trig function? From the angle of elevation, we have opposite, hypotenuse. So the opposite and hypotenuse is our sine function, right? So let's take the sine of our unknown angle X equals 24 over 38. Now, grab your handy dandy calculator. How do we work backwards to angles? We're going to use our inverse button. So clear it out, and let's take the second function, and this time it is of sine. Get your inverse button, put in your ratio of 24 over 38, and let's see what our angle is. Our angle is 39.1, or just 39 degrees. So X is 39 degrees, okay? And we can stop there because that's what the question is asking for. What is the angle of elevation? If we needed to, we could figure this angle out because what do we know? This angle, this acute angle, and this acute angle have a sum of 90. So I'll call that angle Y. So 90 minus 39 is 51. So this angle up here is 51 degrees if we did need to solve it. We didn't, but I at least wanted to extend and go through that with you one more time.